So we have to start with the one commodity case, that is when a consumer arrives at equilibrium, when he consumes only one good, that is one commodity only. So the main assumption of the this theory is the consumer consumes only one good. See, actually this is not the reality. We actually consume more goods, but here the assumption, see, every theory in economics holds in an assumption. So here the assumption is the consumer consumes only one good. So if the consumer is consuming only one good, where he will be arriving at equilibrium? So for that we have to look through the assumptions of the this theory. That is the consumer is assumed to be rational and he consumes only one good, and also the cardinal utility approach is assumed, then diminishing law of diminishing marginal utility operates, then consumer's income is constant and price of the other commodities are assumed to be given. So price of other commodities are given, but they are not consuming that. Only one product at a time, at that particular point of time the consumer consumes. Okay, now we have to look the one commodity case through a schedule diagram as well as a formula. So let us move on to the schedule first. So schedule. So for this schedule, I am taking the, so price is given as 600 and I am taking the example of a shirt. Okay, the consumer is consuming only shirt. So at that particular point of time where the price of the shirt is given rupees 600, he is buying the first shirt, okay, for 700 rupees. Then he is buying the second shirt. See, law of diminishing marginal utility operates. So MU goes on diminishing. When he is not having any dress to wear, he is buying his first shirt. So he will be feeling more utility. And buying his second shirt, that is out of his second income or second salary, or you can take the example, he is in his life, he is getting the first salary of his life. With that, he is purchasing his first shirt of his own. He will be so happy. That happiness is the utility. So that happiness will be more of anything else. Right. So 700. 700 utils. It is utils. Marginal utility is measured in utils. So, and second month salary he is getting. He is buying one more shirt. But you are not, he is not getting the marginal utility as the first shirt. But again still he is getting the utility. So that is 650. What is the addition? What is the this thing? It is 50. 50 is being reduced. Then third month salary, he is again purchasing a shirt. That is 600 marginal utility. That is, he is getting the utility of 600. Again, 50 is being diminished. Here again, third month he is buying the fourth shirt. Again, utility is 500 utils. Again, fifth month, he is buying the fifth shirt. And the utility he arrives at is 350. So that means MU goes on diminishing. That is the first assumption we told. That is, law of diminishing marginal utility operates. So marginal utility is throughout diminishing. First shirt, he got 700 utils, 650 utils, 600 utils, 500 utils, 350 utils. Now you take the price of the shirt. What is the price of the shirt? It is 600 rupees. Now come back to the schedule and find where is the shirt, or where is the unit of that shirt which gives or which satisfies the condition MU of X is equal to P of X. See, P of X is 600, MU of X. So find where MU of X is coming as 600. That is third unit. So when he purchases third unit of shirt, that is the third month salary, he will be in maximum utilization. This is consumer's equilibrium. Okay, this is consumer's equilibrium. In the fourth month and fifth month, he will not be feeling to buy the shirt, because here itself in the third month, he is getting the maximum satisfaction of buying a shirt. So he is in equilibrium where MU of X is equal to P of X. Now coming to the condition, equilibrium condition of the one commodity case, that is ME of X is equal to P of X. In our shirt example, rupees 600 is equal to 600 utils. Okay, so ME of X is equal to P of X, that is consumer's equilibrium. So coming to the diagram of this, you can actually depict in the diagram also. As I told you, see, marginal utility is throughout diminishing, right? But we have not looked through here the zero as well as the negative utility. So that is why it is not crossing x-axis. We have just taken only a part of MU curve. So that is why it is lying above the axis. So this is throughout diminishing. First case is satisfied. Somewhat in the middle, see, it was the third unit of shirt we arrived at equilibrium. So here it is, the MU is 600 and third unit of shirt. Here it is 1, 2, 4, 5, 600. So here first utility is 700, 650, and it goes on like that. Okay, 500, like that it is going on. So we arrived at equilibrium where our MU of X is equal to P of X. So our price is given already, that is 600 rupees. So we arrived at an equilibrium where MU of X is equal to P of X. So this is the one commodity case equilibrium. You have to keep it in mind, the very important condition, equilibrium condition, MU of X is equal to P of X. So whereby the consumer is attaining equilibrium. And coming to the diagram, it is just only a part of marginal utility curve. That is why it is, lying above the axis. So MU of X is equal to P of X. We arrived at the equilibrium E. Okay. So this is the one commodity case. Now we have to look through the two commodity case. In two commodity case, again, assumption is that the consumer consumes only two goods. Okay. So that is two commodity case. In two commodity case, actually you have to just know the concept only. There is no theory to learn for you. You have to just see the concept. So coming to the formula here, it was the you have a same formula or same equilibrium condition as we have shown for one commodity case. The two commodity case formula or condition is ME of X by P of X is equal to ME of Y by P of Y. So simply you can say that the consumer arrives at equilibrium in two commodity case where the ratio of the marginal utility and price of the commodities, price of two commodities are equal. Once again, I am repeating, the consumer arrives at an equilibrium in two commodity case where the ratio of the marginal utilities and price of the two commodities are being equalized or are equal. So that is MU of X by P of X is equal to MU of Y by P of Y. So this is the condition for equilibrium condition for two commodity case. And this is the equilibrium condition for one commodity case. That is MU of X is equal to P of X. So this was the cardinal utility approach propounded by Alfred Marshall and his followers in the year 1851. So, now we have to look through the ordinal analysis that we'll be dealing with in the next class. Before that, I have to tell you that you have to take notes whenever there is required. You have to take notes for, I'll be posting this pictures in the group separately, so you can draw that. So, that is it. So, next class we'll be dealing with the indifference curve approach or the ordinal utility approach. So, that is also all for today.